But I drilled holes in the end of this on three sides. This will be the top by the baffle. I left a little piece of metal here to bend over. And basically, this should fit inside. This should fit inside of this, much like this. I forgot to account for the existing tube that I put in here for the latest test, this guy right here. I don't know what I'm going to do about that yet, but in order to get this in, because of all the modifications I've already made to this can, I think I will have to cut. It might be easiest if I cut the bottom off. If I just put a big slice in here, I can just fit it right up and then re-weld it. If this works, then I would just assemble that during the whole process that you saw me do on the first time. We'll see how it goes. I cut open the bottom of the stove and fit this in, and luckily I didn't plan on it this way. I actually planned on it coming across to right here in the middle, but I don't have to cut this piece out because it sits right in front of it. For testing purposes, that'll be good enough. But I will drill a hole up here, the air will come in, it'll rise up here, come back here, and come in. And this will give it an opportunity to heat up more than any other opportunity I've given it to this up to this point. And what I need to do is put that lid back on and weld it, and should be ready to go. I created this damper to continue my test prototype. Type stove. It's a little loose, looser than I'd like it to be, just around the edges, but it's pretty okay. You can see I had to cut it in an odd shape because of the way this pipe is worn out, this drill pipe. That's the nice thing about CNC though, I can tweak it without much effort. Anyway, I drilled a hole all the way through this pipe. I welded a nut to this side, put in this long bolt, and welded a handle to it that is parallel to the actual damper itself, so I know which angle it's at when I, based on however I have it turned, I know what angle it's at.
Here I am running another test stove. You can see that I have the NeoCeram glass on the side of it, and I am trying to just test some of the modifications I made. However, you might ask yourself, why do I keep testing at night when the camera doesn't pick up any smoke or anything like that? Well, frankly, it's because I just don't have any time other than now. It takes me about a week before I have time to work on this again, and things will lighten up now. The kids' soccer is over and everything, but I'll just do what I can. So basically, I'm testing two things tonight. First, I'm going to be testing one secondary burner, a second secondary burner. I actually have a damper in here besides the baffle, and now with the window on the side, I can see how things are going to be going. Now, I just started the fire, so that's why it looks as dull as it does right now, and there is a lot of smoke in there, and I do, trust me when you can't see it, this is a 6-foot flue now. There is a lot of smoke coming out of the top right now, so I am going to get the temperature up. I do have a heat gun that I purchased, which I just remembered I need to go and grab real quick. And we're going to take some temperature readings on this.
You'll notice that my NeoCeram's holding up fine, but the silicone, which is supposed to resist 2,000 degrees after a 2-hour cure time, is not doing squat. I think the silicone may have been old, and so I may have to cut this test short. We'll see. If it starts to slide down and opens up, then I'm shot, and I'll have to, I do have some other silicone that I ordered. It is here, I just didn't want to open it up because it's in a caulking gun. But I do have a lot of smoke coming. I think it's, actually some oils or something burning off. If that starts to slide down though, we'll figure it out. It is covering up the glass right here, which is not what I want it to do.
And I do have a lot of smoke coming out, as you can see. But it's just starting to warm up. If I show you the temp gun, it's only 173 on the bottom, which is actually, it was about 80 degrees a second ago. It's towards the back, it's not very warm. This is where all the gases should be coming, so it's much hotter there. The top, 400. Flue by the baffle, 300. The front door. I actually thought the front door would be much hotter.
And that silicone stopped boiling. It expanded. And I think we're solid now, other than it blocking a third of my view. Let's see if this will get what's going on the inside. It's kind of hard to say. I don't think so. I think it's the surface of the glass is what it's picking up.
And I see what the smoke is from. I had some oil here. I can't remember what. Oh, the oil is from when I drilled the hole for this. And that's what's burning off right now up here. I wanted to point something out. My temperatures at the flue, at the damper, are in this range. Right before the damper, I'm getting up about 700, close to it. So the stove temperature is still increasing. That's the hottest spot. The next hottest spot is, of course, where the flames are coming up. Interestingly enough, you go to the front and the temperatures drop quite significantly. The air intake, you know, it's much smaller, which I would expect it to be. You go and shoot the sides, and you're in this range. It's not too much. You know, you go towards the back, and the back top, below the, sorry, the baffle. I think I called that the baffle, the damper. You're right below the baffle, and it's not that hot. You approach the front, and your temperatures are increasing. The flame should be going right around here. You can see the laser. They should be going right around here, and that's where our hot temperatures are at. So that tells me, well, and one other interesting thing. Let me shoot the bottom of this. Look at the bottom of that, 646. 575. So we're in the 500 plus range. But then you go and shoot the bottom right here. And anyway, my temperatures earlier that I was reading was much smaller. I was getting a much higher reading off the bottom. So I think your air intake coming along the bottom and then the back and then coming out to the top and exiting somewhere in this range is the best scenario probably to give me a secondary burn. If I shoot the smoke, let me stand up. 6 feet up, if you shoot the smoke, I am getting enough smoke that I'm not getting a secondary burn yet. But we'll keep trying. I'm going to see if I can heat this thing up some more.
The window is blackened enough that I really can't see it through it for any reasonable purposes.
I don't think I'm getting a secondary burn. I think when the fire gets hot enough, it is burning off most of the smoke, because it does dissipate quite a bit, but most of the time you're going to be burning this at a lower temperature anyway, and you have to have the higher temperatures to get that secondary burn. So unless you're going to be running at full force all the time, I don't think you're going to get the secondary burn. I do have one or more tests that I'll probably do, re-clean the window and make a modification and try it, but if that doesn't work, then I don't think it's worth the effort for just a little stove like this. So we'll give it a shot. I just loaded this chuck full of wood, and I'm going to actually shut the door on it. I have some things I need to do inside, so what I'm going to do is I might turn this down halfway or something, but I want to basically go in for maybe an hour, come back out and see how we're doing. I mean, ultimately, you want to be asleep and not have to wake up and refill this constantly. So, you know, if we can get a couple of hours out of it in this small of a stove, that's probably pretty good. If we can't, then... Oh, and I just noticed a problem.
You see that light right there? That silicone that I used is falling apart. I'll have to fix that. Give it some more cure time.
I'm at the top of the flue and there's very little smoke coming out. The temperature has increased. You can actually see the zinc burning off here, and the hotter temperatures in the stove is what's causing it to give a cleaner burn. If I were to choke it down, you'd get more smoke, of course. But I did have a failure. The NeoCeram fell off. I actually took it off because it looked like it was about to fall and I didn't want it to break, so I just took it off, and I'm just going to go ahead and let the fire burn out. It's not a complete loss, though. As soon as I took that off, the air, you know, was able to go in as fast as it needed to. Temperatures increased quite a bit and the smoke died down. So I think I still have a test or two I'd like to run for secondary burning. But the stove has to be hot enough in order for it to just burn cleanly anyway. So what I'm thinking about actually doing is increasing the size of the air intake, or maybe adding a second one. Maybe I could add a side-by-side or something. But I think this air intake is inadequate for this size of stove. And so that's, like I said, it's not a complete loss. This told me that if I were to add the increase the air intake, I can get a much nicer and hotter burn anyway. And at night, you're going to be choking it down anyway. I don't know if you get the secondary burns when you're choking it down anyway. So not too big of a loss there. Anyway, I'm just going to go ahead and let this fire burn down, and we'll call it good for tonight.